Hey everybody. Well, this isn't the video I planned to make, but this happened. Looks like the next project. I actually created a diagram, which I'm gonna show you here, so you can screen capture that or whatever you wanna do. So if you have a drill that's similar to this and you got a bench full of parts, that hopefully you can sort through it and figure out how to put it back together too. So let's get going on this. You're going to start out with your transmission housing. This side goes toward the motor. This side goes toward your chuck. You start out, we're going to have a thin metallic divider plate that will go in. And on the front, there's a fine groove cast in there and one on the opposite side right there. These long tabs fit right in there, and it doesn't matter if it goes in this way or that way on this particular drill. So you'll be able to drop that in and see how it fits within the teeth that are cast into the housing. Next, we're going to take the gear that will go in the front, and there's also one that looks very similar to it for the back. The difference is the teeth that are on the inside of the ring, and on this one, a quick visual identifier is that little notch. There's four of them on the front. There's none of them on the back gear. You're going to have your little shift linkage, kind of horseshoe, half moon shaped linkage, and it drops in to these slots. The teeth and that linkage will go right in there. I can do it without dropping. Hey, there we go. Got it. First try. That's good. And there's a part later on that will move that by grabbing onto those little tabs. All right, the first gear clustered toward the front on the front half of that divider drill looks something like this. It has a hub. Drill looks something like this. It has a hub, five raised stops, and five shafts in the back. And on those shafts, each shaft, there is a little gear that will go on. So that's easy enough. Those just drop on there. This has to go in there. I grab a hold of the little tabs on the side and drop it right in. The next part in assembling the front consists of these pieces. We have five little rollers, this strange octagonal piece with five little arms on one side, and this retainer ring. Now on the front of the assembly, if you can see, there's a fine mark right there. Right here. It runs through. That actually lines up with that. So it drops in like that. The ring goes on. Five little pins drop in. And that's about how the front end looks. We have these parts, another thin retainer and a plastic cast piece. There are two teeth here, one, and one. And where there are two here and there's only one over here, There could be another one right here, but it's missing, and there's a reason for that, because there's something that you'll see in a little bit that goes right where that extra notch would be. This keeper drops right down in here. It should kind of snap in a little bit. There we go. So it shouldn't fall out on its own. One pin is missing. There's two on this side. There's only one on this side. That needs to line up with this hole. And as we can see, these lugs line up in four corresponding cutouts in this. And that's about it. The front half is together. We start out in a similar fashion. We start out with the gear our shift linkage, which is kind of a retainer. With the retainer on the bottom part, I'm just going to thread it in to the groove, roll it over, yeah, it's trying to fall out, and drop it down in there so it's locked in. Now for the first gear cluster toward the rear, we're going to start out with a hub like this. We're going to have 5 gears. So you can just start feeding them on. And then this will drop in there. Now for the next gear cluster, the second cluster toward the rear, we have another hub with 4 shafts and 4 smaller gears that again just slide right on. We'll all drop right down into there. Next, to kind of wrap up the back end, we have another ring gear with a wavy flange on it. We have a thin stamped nylon washer, which fits right over shoulder very nicely. And we have a about not quite a 1/16 of an inch thick wavy washer that it looks like it should go in anyway, but honestly fits better one way than any of the others. It's a little tight right there. If I rotate it, I might find a little bit better mesh. That one's pretty good. Okay, this is ready to go on, but there's one other thing we need to do first. We have these pieces, which go together kind of like this. Drops into that hole right there. Pushes down through, and as you can see, it will come out the front end. Let's beware that little tab was missing on this front retainer, be right about there. So we have this together. Now we take our ring, flip it over and drop it in. Have to roll it back and forth a bit to get it to engage on the gears. And as it's spinning, I don't know if you can see this or not, but those ramps or waves in that rear surface jump over that shift pin. The last thing to go on is this rear transmission plate. And it'll only go on one way, like that. Okay, so now your transmission is all together. And all we have to do is put on the shift cover. Now for the final collar that goes on the front of it. There is a thin spring, stamped spring steel that goes on, fits on like that. There's this little raised locating pin. This will snap down on over all that, and I really need to take my rubber band off for the moment. Hopefully not spill everything. But as you can see, that raised piece in the transmission housing casting fit right in there. Now we need to wiggle this back and forth a little bit to get the transmission linkages to drop into these grooves, the shift grooves. And the last piece to go on is this outer collar that goes on, and it has a little arrow marking both sides that points toward the front of the drill. And this bump snaps right onto that cluster right there. There you go. The transmission is back together.